Good morning. We're here to talk about pruning Honeycrisp to a precise number of buds to help improve cropping annually and get away from biennial bearing. The first thing to do when we're in an orchard is to calculate how many apples the tree should have. Now, this is a really nice tall spindle block, planted 3 by 12, which is 1,210 trees to the acre. At this stage, with it 12 feet tall, it should carry 1,200 bushels on an annual basis. And it turns out that with 1,210 trees to the acre and 1,200 bushels, it's basically one bushel per tree. We expect on Honeycrisp to have 80 count apples. That means 80 apples per tree. Typically on a tall spindle tree at this age, we want 20 branches. Now we call a branch anything that's longer than about a foot. So this would be considered a branch. This is a branch. However, this small little dart with multiple branches is not considered a branch. So I would do a count. I've already counted this tree and it has about 21 branches. The next tree over, I've counted, it has 24 branches. Assuming that we want around 20 branches and only 80 apples, that means we only need 4 apples on each branch. However, we leave a few extra buds. We want 80 apples, but we want to leave some extra insurance buds, and our recommended number is 1.8 times that, which turns out to be 144 buds, divided by 20 branches is about between 6 and 7 buds. Branch. So once we have that number, we then have to count a couple of trees to see how many buds there are. This is easy when it's done near bloom and you can tell exactly how many floral buds there are. It's not so easy earlier. Now we're at the point of getting close to silver tip in this orchard, and so still not exactly obvious which buds are floral. So the best way to try to do that is to take some sample branches and cut them and slice the buds to determine which are floral.
Honeycrisp tree, we took a typical branch and we divided in 20 branches. And from there, we get the little structure, the pruning units. In this case, we had spurs, okay, and we have been cutting and seeing different bud with different density of sizes. And once we had the buds ready to analyze, they are vegetative and floral. We cut, then most of these ones are floral, but the way how we cut the bud, is longitudinal. And with a 10x magnifier, it's very easy to see that this is a floral bud. You see there. Yeah, these are floral. You can see the thing. The picture.
Now that we've cut some buds and figured out which ones are floral, which ones are vegetative, we've done a count on this tree. And this tree only has 80 floral buds. We need 80 fruits. So there are no extra buds on this tree. In fact, this orchard in general, because of a relatively heavy crop last year, does not have very many extra buds on every tree. This situation requires almost no pruning this year. So for this orchard, which looks really nice, when you look down the row, there's no big branches in the top. There's one or two big branches in the bottom. But because of the relatively low number of flower buds per tree, we would suggest that this orchard receive absolutely no pruning. Now, I want to contrast that with a different orchard, which we'll go to in a minute. This orchard had a relatively light crop last year and has loaded with buds. Here we've done similar counts. And these three trees where we'll focus had counts of somewhere around 200 buds, 250, and back down to about 180. This is a similarly spaced orchard, a 3 by 12, so should carry 80 apples. And as we calculated with the previous orchard, we should leave 144 buds. But here, because of light crop and heavy bloom coming this year, some pruning is required to reduce the number of buds from the 200 buds on that tree down to 144. Eliminate 56 buds. On this tree, which is a bigger tree, which has 250 buds, we have to eliminate 106 buds. This tree, which has only 180 buds, we have to eliminate 36 buds. And I want to demonstrate a quick way to try to approach this. Where you have an orchard with too many buds, using the standard tall spindle pruning system, we can get the bud number reduced fairly easily in a systematic way. The first step is identify one or two large branches to remove. This particular tree has a very large branch here. We can remove it and drop some buds on the ground. I want you to notice that last year a big branch was removed down here 2 years ago, and a nice replacement branch has grown. And similarly, on this tree, a big branch is removed. And so this process of removing one branch per year, if done right, will result in a replacement branch. So don't be worried about cutting off the bottom branch. Tall spindle has no permanent bottom branch. What's really critical part with Honeycrisp is the stub should be longer than we use the galen or fuji. This stub was cut 2 years ago very short, no replacement branch. This one was cut longer and a replacement branch. And so we recommend a stub that's about 2 to 3 fingers long. So as I cut this branch, I put my loppers underneath, and I'm going to cut it with a relatively long stub in that manner so that we can get a replacement. That's a 2-finger cut there, or 3-finger on the bottom. So with that one branch, I've dropped some buds on the ground. Remember, this tree had 200, so I need to reduce down to 56. The second step is, after I've removed that one branch, is to simplify all the remaining branches. By that I mean, have just one column of branches. Wherever there's a Y, pick one side or the other to remove. And so I'll probably remove that one there. And that's just one column. And I work my way across each branch. You can't see it really well, but on the other side, it's a heavily branch. I'm going to simplify it. So that's just one branch axis. By that process, I'm also dropping some buds on the ground. I work my way up. This is a branch here that was forked. I'm going to take off one side, so it's just one axis. And the same out here. We'll do the same on every branch as we work our way up the tree until we have simplified all the remaining branches. Now this does two things. It drops some buds on the ground, but also makes the tree more open for better light penetration and better fruit color. This branch here, I simplify it that manner. This one over here, I simplify it by taking off that fork. That's all good up there. So we've now counted the prunings that we dropped on the ground, and we dropped 70 buds on the ground. We started with 200, and we've dropped 70, so we're down to 130. We wanted 144, so we slightly over-pruned our target on this particular tree. But remember, we only need 80 apples, so we still have quite a few extra buds, so it looks proper. With just the two steps of tall spindle, taking out one big branch, and simplifying all the remaining branches, we got really close to the target number. Now the next tree has 250 buds, and so it'll take more buds on the ground. But that leads to this important point. There's variability across an orchard. Some trees bigger and some trees little. You can tell by the size of the trunk in a way. And so pruners have to be attuned to this. We hope that in the future, machine vision will be able to count these buds for us. But for now, we recommend that the pruners every once in a while stop and count how many buds they're leaving on a tree to sort of calibrate themselves whether they're pruning too little or too much. I reemphasize, this is for orchards with heavy bloom, and many Honeycrisp orchards have heavy bloom this year, so they should be pruned to a specific bud number that relates to the final fruit number. In this case, it's 80 apples. We want to leave 144 buds. So if several times during the day, the pruner will stop and count to see how many buds he's leaving. It should be somewhere around 144, we hope. Now we'll finish talking about the next tree, which is a much bigger tree by the size of the trunk. It has more buds, and so the pruning has to be more. This tree doesn't have any really large branches like the previous one. We can hopefully take out one branch, maybe two, the biggest one, because I always like to take out one. So I'm going to take out this one branch here because it's not that great. So we'll leave a 2- and 3-finger stub to get a replacement. The most important thing for this, to drop buds on the ground because it's got way too many buds, is to simplify the remaining branches. So this branch here, we can take off one side of it and drop some buds on the ground. That's a simple little step there. On the back side, you can't see, but take off one side. Now the simple axis, this one here, right there. It's a way to drop buds on the ground, but still keep branches intact so the tree doesn't respond with too much vigor. We'll continue our work to take off forks of all the branches.
Now let's stop and count.
So we're counting most of the pruning that was done in the tree. And I array with 35.
Now remember, this tree had 250 flower buds, and our goal was to remove it down to 144, which would be to drop 106 on the ground. We've now dropped 66, so there's still 40 more buds on that tree that we should drop. This requires spur pruning, artificial spur extinction. Remember that each major branch, we have 22 branches, so each one needs only about 6 buds on it. And so what we can do is simply take off the down buds or the little thin, narrow buds that produce small-sized fruit. And we can just do some of this until we can reduce it down, or shorten the ones that are pendant, reduce it down to 144 buds. And we continue to do that kind of step until we have that number of buds on the ground. We finished the spur pruning step. We've now dropped an additional 44 buds on the ground. So that tree, because of heavy flowering, now has 144 buds. I would have you notice that trees that have a lot of flower buds look a little bit sparse when you're done with the pruning, because almost every bud is floral. In contrast to the first orchard we were in, which had only a few flower buds, we did no pruning, the tree might look a little thicker. But it's based on the number of flower buds. So where we have an excessive flowering, the trees will look more open textured like this. And where we have relatively few flower buds, the trees will receive no pruning. By that method, we can control the number of flower buds every year and avoid biennial bearing.